Good evening, Munanda. Welcome to the Mental Health Webinar Series 2020 and 2021. Today, the session number is 502. Today, we are going to see the topic Happiness Ladder, Bank and Course by the resource person, Mrs. Syamala Jayaram. She is the founder of Progressive Minds Training Academy. She is a trainer, healer, life and wellness coach. She is having the overall 40 years industry experience. Out of that, she is in having the training in 17 years. She is a fellow of Insurance Institute of India. She is certified soft skill trainer. She is a neuro-linguistic programming master trainer with NLF USA. She is advanced practitioner of law of attraction and Ho'oponopono. She conducted a lot of workshops, particularly in NLP, emotional freedom, chakra balancing, and change management. And she done a lot of training program for the corporate in terms of interpersonal skills. She almost covered 25,000 participants on various topics. She gave the training. And she called Syamala Jayaram Sharma. I would like to invite today's resource person and all the participants on this wonderful evening for this mental wellness of American College, Madurai, Madras School of Social Work, Chennai, MS Chellamuthi Institute, Madurai, Red Point Educational and Psychological Resource Center, Madurai, Yellow Part Counseling Center, and association called Tamil Nadu Career Counseling and the Tamil Nadu Counseling Psychotherapy Association. Kind note, I would like to invite today's resource person, Mrs. Syamala Jayaram. Ma'am, over to you.
Thank you so much for having me here today, and it's such a pleasure to be, coming to this platform again for on this mental health issues. Thanks for giving this opportunity. Thanks to American College. Thanks to TNCPA. Thanks to Yellow Pond Counseling. Thanks to Red Pond Counseling. Thanks to Madras School of Social Work and all the other allied institutes which are a part of this particular mental health webinar series. So today's topic is Happiness Ladder. Happiness Bank and Happiness Quest. So I would share my PPT now, and thanks to all the participants too. I'm audible, no?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, you are audible. Yeah.
So I don't have to put my headset. Okay, so let's start with a little input from the participant itself. So when we say about happiness, what is happiness? Don't think about anything right, wrong, whatever comes to your mind when we say what is happiness.
Being peaceful, ma'am.
Okay, great. Being peaceful. Somebody else? Anyone else?
Satisfaction, contentment.
Satisfaction and contentment. Yes, great, great. Anyone else?
Being peaceful.
Being peaceful. Okay.
So within us, ma'am.
Huh?
Within us.
Within us. Absolutely. That is what is most important. Within us. So happiness is an emotional state characterized by feelings. So basically, happiness itself is a feeling, and it's a feeling of joy or satisfaction, contentment and fulfillment. These are some of the things the other participants, whatever you have said is also right and true. It's also about balancing the emotion. We are not always positive. So there has to be a, balance between, we do undergo negative emotions too. So how do we balance this positive and negative emotion or feelings or moods and still remain happy? That's very important. And it is also generally linked to experience more positive feelings than negative. So when we talk about happiness, naturally I have to be on the positive side so that I can remain happy. So what is happiness quotient according to you? We described happiness as few words. Now what is happiness quotient, or what gives you happiness? Happiness may not be same for all of us. For each one of us, it may be different. So according to you, what is your happiness quotient?
Thinking more positive.
Okay. What else? What else could be happiness according to you? Happiness quotient. Confidence. What makes you happy?
Confident make us very happy, ma'am.
Confidence, okay. If you are confident,
making
you are very happy.
Making somebody to feel happy.
Your voice is breaking, ma'am.
Making someone to feel happy. Making someone to
making
make
someone
smile.
To feel happy. Okay. Then?
Making someone to feel smile. If they smile, we can able to feel happy, no?
Absolutely. Okay. With your smile itself, you can make people happy. Correct. Okay. So let us see what else is happiness quotient. So actually, when we see in reality, or today's greatest, modern day lie, what we can say is that I'm happy only when I'm equating my happiness with material wealth, you know, consumerism, what all things I have, what all luxuries I have, or either, you know, if I smoke, I drink, I party. These are the things actually makes me happy. There are a lot of people now into all these things, and they feel that when I have achieved and when I have collected all these things in my life, all these things are available in my life with me, then I'm very happy. It could be like a big house, swimming pool, car, luxuries. So this defines our status. This defines me as my identity, and I feel very happy after that only. But there are someone who, if you would like to hold on to someone during tough time, you have a good family life, you're enriched with love, peace, and hope. So that is actually the true happiness. Because if you have all these things, probably other things become easier to acquire also, and other things may not matter too much also. So is your happiness dependent on something? As long as I'm making happiness, my happiness dependent on having all these sort of things, so that is all external factors which is making me happy. So when somebody said that, you know, within me, so that's what we are looking. When I am happy within myself, being myself, that is very important. And that is the without depending on anything when I'm very happy. Having legs, hands, ears, eyes, heart, mind, etc. Because if I have this, I can do anything. If I don't have it, there are a lot of people who are not fortunate enough to have all these things, are, you know, so much of, they are troubled with disease. Their life is full of so much of issues. When I have all this thing intact, I can go ahead, work hard, plan my life properly, and, you know, be really happy. So if I have all these things itself, that the happiness starts from there, because I have what I wanted to make it happy and move forward in life. Now, there is a Chinese proverb which says that if you want to be happy for an hour, take a nap. Okay, take a small nap or rest. If you want to be happy for a day, go fishing. If you want happiness for a month, get married. So getting married is equivalent to happiness for 1 month here. If you want happiness for an year, inherit a fortune. And if you want happiness for a lifetime, then help someone else. Somebody was saying that if I can smile, if I can help someone else, that is a different kind of happiness, which also should come without any expectation. When we do the help, we expect that person to thank us, to be nice to us, all those expectations also. If it is not happening, then it becomes conditional. If it is not happening, those things are not there, that they are not appreciating me, they have not acknowledged me, then again, I go through a lot of hurt and pain. So really, happiness doesn't happen there in that case. So it is like I have put this ladder here. Normally we climb up the ladder. Anything we signify is growing up is when you go up the ladder. So if you, happiness is such that it has to keep growing. Like how the ladder, as you keep climbing the ladder, more and more happiness you need to keep on adding. And then create a loop of happiness. So how do we create a loop of happiness as I keep adding more and more happiness? And how do I add happiness also? We are going to see all those things. But for this, you have to put some effort, right? Anything that you want, when you want a pleasure, there is a pain involved there. Are you ready to work? Are you ready to put some effort there? Then we can keep climbing up the happiness ladder. Are you going to become tired and say, no, this is not my cup of tea? Then probably it will be short-lived. So how we are, and actually, like you said, what all things I can do for me to become happy, to bring that happiness within me also, we are going to see, right? And so you have to keep on adding these things. What are the things that you have to add to make you more and more happier and more satisfying in life? So as per law of attraction, it says like attracts like. It's like a magnet. You know, we say birds of the same feather flock together. So whatever I like, it will attract those things only for me. If I'm attracting what I don't like, then it is actually not law of attraction happening there. Whatever I like, again, so like will attract like. Or repetition attracts repeatedly. So now law of attraction does not say what is right, wrong. It is up to you to decide what you want in your life. So if you are going to attract negativity, it is going to, you will be reeling in the loop of negativity. It depends on how fast you are able to come out, break out, or understand certain things which are not very comfortable for you, or which makes you sad, or which makes you more negative. How long are you going to delve in those negative feelings? If you are able to come back fast and bounce back fast from that, how resilient you are, then you can keep on adding more happiness to your, you know, this happiness loop. So they say, sow you sow, so you reap. So what are my thoughts? My thoughts are actually, so we say mind and body, body and mind both work together. So if I'm sick in my mind, if I have all wrong thoughts in my mind, if I'm having all limited beliefs, or my belief system itself is very faulty, all the actions that I take is faulty, then where is the question? I'm going to attract that only to me. So whatever I sow, I'm going to reap. That's what we say in karma also. What karma is nothing but what we sow, what we that is what we are going to reap, right? And this law of attraction, it works 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So it's always on. It all depends on what is your dominant thought, whether it is positive, negative, what actions are you taking, what is the thought process, what are the internal talks that you're doing. Everything is a loop there. So it depends. Now, law of attraction works only if it is positive. I cannot say that it is successful. Even if you are in a negative mode and you are attracting all negative things, the law of attraction is working. So you have to decide what you have to choose, because it is working continuously, right? And even in your sleep, the universe is listening to your emotions and thoughts. So what happens is, supposing you're going to write an exam the next day, and when you go to sleep, most probably we are, you know, thinking about whether I'm going to pass, fail, or somebody may, if that person is very positive, try to recollect all those question answers in the night. Somebody may be a little scared, so be thinking whether, how am I going to write this exam? What kind of questions are going to come in on? And as you doze off with all these thoughts in your mind, you would most probably be dreaming about that exam, something. Maybe the bus is missing, I miss my, the number or my identity card, or I have got a plate, and, you know, you will see that you are not able to reach anywhere. It could be any kind of those thoughts, which are a dream, which would be associated with what you thought. So that is why we say, even in the night, the universe is listening to your emotions and thoughts. And that's why they say, don't go to sleep with any hard feelings, with any negative thoughts, with a lot of stress, because that is what you're going to, again, early morning also when you get up, probably you'll be getting up with those similar kind of thought patterns only. And remember that the universe is constantly rearranging factors that deal directly or indirectly with you, so that these desires will materialize in physical reality. So which means, if you are in a negative thought, it is going to provide you opportunities, or it is going to reveal opportunities, people, situations, events, which are just matching to that, because you have attracted negative thought. But if you are in a positive thought, then it is going to attract more and more positive events, opportunities, people, situations in your life. So it is working 24 hours of the day. So what is this happiness band? So this is my happiness band here, right? If you can see that. It's a very small book I maintain, so that I maintain 3-4 books like that. So one is my happiness band. In a bank, we either deposit or withdraw, correct? So I want you to deposit. What do I deposit here? First is to create a happiness bank like this, to create a, start writing a happiness journal. And so what do I write there? Whatever brought a smile to your face. It could be any mundane thing. I like the food which I ate. You know, I'm very happy about that. Somebody called me and it really changed my mood. Then I'm going to write some music I did, some gardening I did. anything. We are not talking about some huge target achievement and all, nothing like that. Any smallest thing which has brought smile to your face, immediately write it down. Or at least before you go to sleep, recollect everything and write it down. Yesterday, actually, I was traveling. Currently, I'm in Gujarat. I came to my mom's house and my flight was scheduled. It was a direct flight from Chennai to Ahmedabad. But what happened is, in the last moment, once I booked with SpiceJet, I had to cancel it because they rescheduled. First, they made it from morning, early morning flight to evening flight. I have to travel from Ahmedabad another 350 kilometers. And all because of Corona, somebody has to come from my place to come and pick me up. Remember, in car and night driving is very unsafe also. And then they rescheduled it again, SpiceJet. From morning 8, I start there from Chennai. Night, Ahmedabad, I reach at 8:20. So we canceled it. They were very happy to refund us. And then we rescheduled it with GoAir. Same, they booked by afternoon flight, direct flight, and they rescheduled it. Rescheduled it next day morning. I'm getting a message saying that it has been rescheduled. And same, this similarly, 8:20 flight, I reach Bombay at 10 o'clock. And I'm there in the airport till 7. And I was a little worried whether I'll be reaching Gandhidham so that I can take this session today. And last minute only, this was decided while sitting in the airport lounge. I did all my PPT. I prepared my PPT, most of the PPT there only, though Saturday I prepared little. And all the fine tuning I did sitting there, I utilized my time. That's why really I was thankful that even though in this situation, I had time to retune my or refine my PPT. In the meanwhile, I also did 2 therapies from that lounge itself for my daughter. So I don't know how this time went away, and at 7:20 I got into the flight. So it went off very, very well. So immediately I wrote it that, thankfully that it, whatever it may be the difficulties, but what I saw was, what made me happy is that I could fine tune my PPT. I could do therapy for my daughter sitting there nicely without any, issues there. So smallest of detail you have to record in this every day, because we are, what happens when you keep depositing money again and again, does your money increase? So your happiness is also going to increase. We are creating a loop of happiness. We want to first acknowledge what all things we have, what all things makes us happy, then focusing on what is not going good for me, what issues are I am facing. We let us not focus on that. And as you keep writing this, you'll be, the first day you write, second day you write, that excitement grows, okay, what do I have to write today? What good things have happened? And as the excitement goes, remember that your body language is changing, your mood is changing, everything is changing there. So minutest of detail, please make an entry. Remember it consciously and keep it in place where it's visible to you. Now I can forget, right? I would have felt happy. I will think, oh yes, I'm going to enter this. But what will happen? Where do I keep this book? So keep it where you can see it daily so that before you go to bed, you're definitely writing this. Do not skip it. Okay. And how do you phrase it? I'm very happy today because you can write those various things. This happened, that happened. Or if it is one month thing, I'm very happy today. Make the main heading and under that, keep writing what all things, gave you happiness on that day. So create a happiness bank. So first we said about that, we are all having a happiness ladder. Ladder means when I keep climbing up, but I want to climb up with happiness and keep on gathering more and more happiness. Now I'm going to deposit into each step I take, each happiness that I get, I'm going to deposit in my happiness bank. So this daily journal will be your happiness bank where you'll make deposits every day. Every day, the effort of writing entries on this journal will help you attract inspired action. So what will happen is as you keep writing it, you automatically will, you will unconsciously start taking some action because your body language has changed. There is some enthusiasm in you. There is some energy increase more. So automatically you will start taking action so that you further attract more and more happiness in you. So the inspired action is the direct result of law of attraction. That is how the law of attraction will work for you. Now, payment journal and happiness bank. How is that concerned? What is this payment journal? So you'll have to create one more small notebook. What is that small notebook? Payment journal. We are not happy when we have to pay something, right? We are always feeling bad that I have to pay something, but I'm very happy to receive. But only because you have the paying capacity, you're going to pay. Or they say, walk as if you are the most richest person, talk as if you are the most richest person, act as if you are the most richest person, dress as if you are the most richest person. You don't have to, when you say most richest person, you don't have to buy costly clothes, but the way you dress yourself, even though you may be wearing some 200 rupees of cotton shirt, it will look as if you are so great. So, you know, when you feel bad, don't feel bad about it, because it shows your paying capacity and what you want. Now, a lot of people say that when we, you know, have for this workshop and all, everybody will show a lot of interest. But when it comes to payment, they will say, oh, this much you have to pay. Now, I remember when I was doing a class, in that class, they told that if you have the money to pay for this class. So even I was thinking whether I should pay or not pay, or what we need to do. Now, if you want what we said in law of attraction, that whatever is your thought, it will attract. So you won't know if you are dead sure and you are really wanting to attend some workshop or buy certain things, however costly it may be. If you have set your eyes on that, I don't want you to use law of attraction for bad things. Whatever is goodness, what brings goodness in your life for everybody around you. So if you have the desire, you can definitely, if you say that, yes, universe, I want this and I'm placing this demand and I'm ready to receive. Don't bother about logic. How will I be able to buy such a costly stuff? I don't have money even for a two time to eat food. All these things, if you start thinking, you are analyzing and finding logical things and sitting in a problem. So nothing is going to work for you in that case. If you want something, just place your demand and be willing to receive and start doing action for that. Whatever action you can do for that, start doing it and things will start moving for you. So when you have to pay something, as you are very happy to receive money, be very happy to pay money also. So write that also. Whatever you are making payment per day, you could, you know, summarize, this is the total amount I've paid towards what are the items that you have bought. So write it. If you have paid, given to someone, if you have bought something, whatever you have spent, money spent, don't take it as gone from your, purse or from your hand, but think that it is going to get more money because I have the spending capacity. I have to do, justify your needs, why you need this. And then automatically you will start getting money. I want to buy this because it is going to give me this benefit. So I want this. Universe, help me in getting this. So this is the way you have to do it. Don't get into, please, logical thinking. Then you are getting into problem. You are unnecessarily sitting and analyzing. Nothing is going to work for you. If Dhirubhai Ambani would have sat and thought all those things, I don't think so. He would have, you know, he was uneducated. He used to sell bhaji bonda in some hill in Saurashtra in Gujarat. He had nothing, no education, nothing, you know, but he had only one thing. He knew that how to work hard, and he knew only that he has to keep, you know, growing up in life, and he had already decided that this is what I want to be. And as he kept that desire itself, you know, brought all those event opportunity people for him. There are n number of people. There are children today who are auto rickshaw drivers, children who are doing topping in CA. What background do they have? You know, their parents cannot teach them. They cannot speak English. They cannot read books. But imagine a girl, auto rickshaw driver's daughter, clearing a CA, that took, coming first, not clearing, coming first all over India 2 years back. So if you see, there are all these examples, replete with all these examples, latest, whatever we have seen in Olympics, each of them have come with such poor background, but still they have made it till Olympics, to the highest forum they have made. So it is all how you decide and go ahead with that. So what payments mean to you here? Is it that something, money going out of my hand and, you know, feeling bad? Please don't feel bad that. Make payment every day with happiness. You want to spend on something, place your demand to the universe, trust the process and be ready to receive. And do not make any payment with heavy heart. Remember, it only signifies your paying capacity. So happiness bank is your credit and payment bank is your debit, but both are going to bring you only goodness here. When we say debit, it is supposed to be whatever is going from my hand, but whatever is going from your hand, be happy that you have the paying capacity and that is why it is going from your hand. So make your deposits every day in the happiness bank, make entries for all payments that you make. Remember, in those days, our parents used to sit and make an account. Maybe you brought a provision, you don't have to write really all the provision, just the amount that you spent. So every day, the effort of writing entries in these journals will help you again attract inspired action. So what is inspired action? It is the direct result of law of attraction. So something you will start moving towards prosperity in every term. When I say prosperity, I never mean money here. I mean money, health, happiness, everything. That is what is prosperity according to me. And happiness quest. So we created happiness bank, we created happiness ladder, we added payment journal to it because that is going to bring more happiness to me. Happiness quest. So what can make you happy? Every day, what can make you happy? Other than whatever news you are automatically receiving, we are receiving. But from your side, would you like to contribute something to make yourself happy? So that is called happiness quest. So try to discover one thing that would make you happy. That would probably, it could be anything. Say you have never done gardening, maybe go and do some gardening. Cook something which is totally different. It could be talking to friends. These are all we are doing so that when we do these things, it brings us happiness. So you are going to go in search of finding an activity which will bring happiness to you. It could be more watching movies. Whole week you have not watched. Go and watch one movie. But remember, no, don't keep on watching movies which are, you know, full of crying and sadness. Reading, painting, cycling, swimming. What is new for you? Eating something you like from outside. You know, do something different, which is an activity which will derive happiness to you. So every day, one activity. It doesn't have to be again very big, just a smallest of activity, something which is different, which you don't do on a regular basis, right? So whatever you think of it, it has to bring a happiness, measure of happiness for you. Now let us do one small activity for that is a neuro-linguistic way of, you know, warding off the negativity. Sometimes what will happen, suddenly negativity comes and how do I may be distracted, I may be more focused on the negativity. So how fast can we come out of it? Now I want you all to just think of one negative event. It could be somebody criticizing you, it could be something you lost, anything, any small event. Don't take too heavy event, you can take a smaller event. Somebody, you fought with someone, or contract probably you lost, something like that, any negative event. Is everybody ready with one negative event? I'll give it 3-4 minutes, take time to, yeah. Let me see whether everybody is also.
2 years back, I met an accident.
Ah, okay. Now, next what I want. Yeah, ma'am.
2 years back, I met an accident.
So for 2 years back, you met an accident. What was the accident? Why did it happen?
It is in Bangalore. I left my daughter in the school. Mm. After that, 8 o'clock, I passed the road. 10:30, I was in hospital. Mm. I forgot 2 hours.
Okay.
And then
I forgot 2 hours.
Yeah. Then I went to Chennai, my parents' house. My father took me. And after coming to Bangalore back, the hospital people told I myself admitted.
Okay. So, you yourself got admitted.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they said that what was happened, the 2 hours will not come back.
Oh, okay. You don't recollect that.
Recollected. But every time I feel happy, then also the action, I feel it is negativity.
Okay, fine. See, one way of getting rid of that memories can never be erased totally, remember that, but you can bring down the intensity of those feelings. This is a smaller exercise. You can participate in that, but in future, if you want, you can contact me for removing that kind of, I won't say removing, bringing down completely the intensity of that. My daughter also underwent a severe accident. But today she doesn't remember and she drives all those things, you know, it will be out of your mind. That's what I would say. The memory as such will remain in your mind, but it becomes inconsequential for you. So you can take that. So what would be your positive memory in that case? Something which you did confidently?
I admitted myself, ma'am. I went, I usually went to the hospital. I removed the helmet. I went to the hospital. I called my parents, my husband. and I never cried anywhere. I admitted myself, and somebody of my friends, my husband's friend, came and discharged me because he went to US.
Okay.
I was really proud of that. I admitted myself. I never cried anywhere.
Great, great. So you can probably club both. First, we will go to the negative event, then we'll get into the positive event, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Good. So can we go ahead with this? So have one positive. If it is sadness, maybe positive. If your negative event is pertaining to sadness, choose something which is a positive memory, which is with happier. You know, exactly. Or if possible, if you can choose your positive memory to be the opposite of the negative memory. It could be event. Take it more as an event, or even somebody criticizing me. If somebody has criticized you for someone, but there is some other person who has praised you so much. So that can be taken into positive, and this can be taken as negative. Right? When we do it with neuro-linguistic program, there is something called anchoring and all. I'm not getting into those kind of things. It's a very simple way of doing things. Right? So close your eyes, all of you. And I just want you to go through that negative event of what happened, where it started and where it ended. What all you saw, you heard, and you felt. We don't have to really go too very deep, but whatever you can recollect of that negative event. Just recollect the whole thing. Just see it once. And that's why I told you not to take a very deep negative memory, preferably something which is very light. It could be even somebody, early in the morning, you have a fight with your spouse. Even that could be taken. Okay, now open your eyes. Just notice the surroundings wherever you're sitting. Yeah. Now I want you to close your eyes again and go into the positive memory. Now recollect this positive memory right from the beginning where it happened. See it clearly. Now, as you feel happy about that positive memory, as you keep going through this positive memory, recollecting the details, and as it gives you happiness, now I want you to make it bigger and bigger. This particular happiness, if you can zoom it, as if you zoom it, how it is shown everywhere. Make it 3D. Zoom it, make it big, and make it 3D, that it is seen everywhere. And see yourself bloating with that energy, positivity, and happiness. Make it big. Yeah, zoom it. Enjoy and feel happy. Enjoy that moment. See all the colors. See the environment. Whatever you felt at that time. Zoom it, make it big, make it 3D. And feel energized. Open your eyes. Now, what I want you to do is this negative event itself, again, we are going to see, but as if, you know, it is happening in all positive way, how this positive memory happened, that negative, if now you are remembering how it is now going in your mind or how positively you are dealing with that. So close your eyes. And now see the negative event happening in a very nice way. It is not leaving any bad taste in your mouth. You feel very comfortable with that particular event now. See, as if it is already happening in a better way. Yeah, slowly you can open your eyes. Just think of what was your lunch today? And now just close your eyes. And if you think about this negative event once again, try to recollect it. Just see how you feel. Close your eyes and try to get back into that negative event. Yes, so you all can open your eyes. So what was it that you got when you went back to going through that negative event? Did you really see that negative event, and how was it? How did you feel? Or you saw something else? Okay, so we will chat later now. Now let us move further. Gratitude leads to happiness and abundance, correct? So when we were talking about happiness, we cannot leave out gratitude out of it, because that is one thing which will add to your happiness. So again, you are going to write a gratitude journal also. So probably in a notebook, you can devote 50 pages for happiness journal, probably 50 for payment journal, and then another 50 for gratitude journal. You can also have it like that, or three small books. Now, in this gratitude journal, what is the most important thing is that whatever you have, first you acknowledge that. So every day that you have food to eat, every day you have to write that, thank you, God. Now, how do you start this sentence? It has to always start with thank you. And when we thank you, it is about God. If you want specifically, you can write God also. So thank you, God, for food, health, abundance, good family life, loving family members, whatever you have. All those things that you have, please write it there. Because every day, let us acknowledge what we have with us. The first thing, it starts with acknowledging what we have with us. Like I would even thank my domestic help there, because she's an everyday factor and she gives me a lot of relief. So I am really thankful to her. And you will also see the vibration between you and your domestic help improving like anything. Whoever you have tussle with, thank you, that person. Why would I thank you, a person with whom I'm having tussle? Because you want more of comfort level there. You want more love and respect from that person only. The people who are there in your already bringing happiness in your life, acknowledge them, thank them also. But where you need to focus more is people here, in terms of people or situations, events which is not going good for you, thank them also. So what you have, wherever things are not working well for you, thank all those event, people, situations. So people will say, why would I thank my enemy? Now remember, you're not going to thank your enemy in front of them so that your ego doesn't come in between. It is only in your mind or whatever you're writing there, and you will see the change happening. Anything you want to achieve, thank you that I have already constructed a house, or thank you, I have registered a house in my name already, right? Thank you, I already have this, you want a bag, so I already have this bag now. So whatever you want to achieve, write it as if it has already happened, already you have achieved. That is what is as if frame. So how to phrase the sentences? Starting with thank you only you have to start. Now this is one way of doing where you acknowledge day-to-day things also, but you have a very specific goal. Supposing you want to achieve a specific goal, then you can write separately in a yellow paper with red ink, right? So what you can do, like this is the yellow paper. Can you all see? You can take this yellow paper, preferably take a red colored pen, and morning 3 times you write about that. Thank you for my daughter getting admission, or thank you for my child turning a new leaf. If you're having a trouble with so and so family member or whatever, that is your whatever is your immediate important target. You can do it differently also. Morning you are going to write about it 3 times. Afternoon you can write it about that same thing 6 times. Night before you go to sleep, you're going to write about it 9 times. But see whether it is doable for you, because at least for minimum 30 days you have to write this in a yellow paper, whatever you want to achieve. And start with thank you only. So we call it as 369 formula by Abraham Hicks. So you can do this also. It is little tough. Some people may give it up. So, but it will definitely bring results for you. Morning 3 times, afternoon 6 times, night before you go to sleep 9 times. So that is why I'm telling you, take one goal at a particular time, because you may not be able to sit and write, two goals you write, then this will get multiplied. Remember that. So take one major goal at a time and do this way also. Now, ego, why are we all not happy? Whenever we have ego, ego means misery, correct? What is ego here? First of all, it is all darkness, ego means. So when I'm judging people in a negative way, when I'm getting offended, when I insult others, when I feel jealousy, when I keep having anxiety for small, small things, when I try to compete with people and I feel very threatened by competition, when I feel shamed, or any other negative feelings based in fear also, all this will keep causing you misery only, right? So if you have, so ego means misery. When you are all indulging in all these things, that is why we say, go within, these are all external factors which is affecting you and which is ruining your peace of mind. So when we say go within, doesn't mean that you have to stop leading a normal life or you have to become a sadhu santana. Your way of looking things can definitely change. So first, if you can take not being judgmental, you see somebody wearing some clothes, immediately you form an opinion, you become judgmental about that. Don't do that. You don't know that person at all. Even if you know, that is that person's choice. So simple, simple things like that. Feeling jealousy. When somebody is more richer than us, we want to become like that. We are not becoming like that, and we are feeling jealous also, and we attribute all kind of wrong things to their success. Maybe he's doing a shortcut to success, he's a fraud, or he will keep on muskifying, that is why he comes up in life. We attribute all kind of wrong things rather than looking for the work that has been put on by that person. And if that person is really adopting all shortcut methods to success, he himself will move away after some time. He will vanish in thin air. Why you have to waste your time and energy for that? So the ego is which is grounded in fear, and anything that it thinks comes from a place of fear. Remember that. Fear of competition, fear of jealousy, everything you are scared of that, and you think about everyone in a negative term. All these are ego, which means we are more bothered about our external world. We are still in external factors. They all impact us so much that it, impacts our happiness. No one can hurt you other than you yourself. Nobody has the power to hurt you. It is all the meaning that you give to some comments made by some people. So what, how you treat, how you look into that, how you feel about it is under your control. What is under your control, you do that. We are trying to control everything, other things in the world. But what is within my control to go within myself, I don't do that. So do that. A simple way of coming out of this ego, or again, warding off negativity, is this bathing meditation. This is a Zen meditation. It is written in our Upanishad also, but probably we in India never, all of us read those Upanishad, but the Zen masters have taken this bathing meditation and they have used this for, you know, coming out of this negativity. So what do you do? We all know that when you're scared, when you're anxious, people ask you to, when you're crying, people ask you to drink water. Water, what's of negativity? It brings down your anxiety. It brings down your fear. It brings down your anger, right? So taking bath itself, they say that the best way to come out of negativity is when you're taking bath. So as you take bath, so all of you close your eyes. How do we do this bathing meditation? Of course, I'm going to do it in 2-3 minutes time, but you can do it for 10 to 15 minutes. Take that much time to take bath, even 1 hour if you have time. It all depends. So imagine standing under a shower. And as you open the tap, that nice cold water feeling and falling on your body. And as the water drips down, you feel so comfortable and so happy. That anger, that restlessness, that anxiety slowly going down. Ensure that the water falls all over your body. And you can actually 10 minutes enjoy just thinking of that water falling on your body. At that particular moment, do not think of anything else because this is a water meditation. So as the water drips down your body, as it touches your body, you feel so nice, so comfortable, and so relieved. Now imagine taking the water, the soap, and scrubbing all over your body. Does it remove only your dirt? No. It also, as you keep soaping your body, think of all those negativity which is going and getting washed away with that. Everything is just going from your body, getting washed away from your body. You feel so energized. You feel so nice. It is not only the dirt from your body, but all the filth that we have gathered in your mind is also getting washed away. And take as much as time as you want to keep on getting that positive feeling. And that nice cold water which is falling all over your body, wash off all the negativity. Feel refreshed, feel nice. And as you dress up and come out, your sole of the feet is still wet. So you are just stepping onto the rug and wiping your legs there. And as you step out from that, you feel completely energized and cherished. In actual terms, you can really do this for 10 minutes in the bath, just enjoying the shower. I've done it for very fast here, but the soaping process, the first initially, the watering on your body, again, washing off the soap on your body. Each one, you can take 5 minutes and enjoy that whole process and just be, look within. Do not think of any external factors of who has hurt you, who has told you anything. What are the things that you have to do that day? You are getting late. And don't bring any of those thoughts. So do this meditation when you really have time, at least 15 to 20 minutes, where you can devote just for this and enjoy the whole process. Now, when we talk about happiness, we don't see pain inherent in pleasure, right? We are only thinking about the pleasure, momentary pleasure. Like you are a chain smoker, somebody is continuously drinking, you know, all these things which gives us only momentary pleasure. But beyond that, what is going to happen? So happiness in a shorter term, just for the moment, but which actually spoils your body, spoils your health, spoils your peace of mind. If something you are doing which is not going to cause any harm, that is fine, right? But if it is going to give you only pain in future, then that happiness is really not worth it. Your headlight of the car, if you see, if it is a very powerful headlight also, maybe up to 50 meters, you will be able to see the light there. Beyond that, it is going to be only darkness. So we are seeking pleasures and searching in the outer world. And we are constantly adjusting with things, being, situation, events. With all this planning, we're still not finding happiness within. So if you understand the I which is causing, the ego which is causing all this misery, and move ahead with your life, probably there will be more happiness, so that external factors do not, you know, bother you. Why is happiness not available to you? Because I'm into blame game. If something happens to me, I immediately want to put a blame. My boss is bad, so this work didn't go happen. Because my boss is very, person who does a lot of favoritism or partiality, that is why I did not get promoted. If for everything, you know, we put the blame on others. We all have enough choices. We all are capable of making decisions. If you have made a particular choice, which at that particular moment you thought was correct for you, then that is your own choice. But you had other choices also. So you opted for that choice. So then don't resort to blame game. Accept how you can, if you can set right the situation, take the responsibility of your action and take set right. Competition. The more you try to fight competition, the more you're going to attract competition. Same is jealousy. Because law of attraction is what? You will feel, okay, this person is a competitor for me. Let me see how I can pull this person down. One person you pull down. Now somebody else will come again. One more person will sprang up. So you will be in the process of only trying to beat your competitors and trying to bring them down rather than looking for your growth. So look for your growth and don't bother about that competition. Everybody has got enough space in this universe, enough opportunities, enough things which will help you or aid you in achieving whatever you want. Don't be bogged down or bothered about competition and spend all your energy concentrating to fight that competition. See how you can, you know, grow yourself, how you can make a better version of yourself. Try to compete with yourself rather than competing with others. Each step, try to beat yourself. Hate. When we hate, there is no happiness. Because hate is such a powerful emotion and all of us are so much involved in hating. That where is the happiness for that? So do I have to hobnob with the people who are trying to harm me? No, not necessarily. You can avoid them. But you don't spend your energy thinking about those people or trying to hate them. Why do you want to even try to hate them? That hating itself is a powerful negative energy and emotion that you are wasting. So just simply forget them from your life. Procrastination. You know you have to do something. You don't do, you keep feeling guilty. Then you keep cursing yourself. Again, you don't feel happy. You come out with a lot of excuses. You have to reduce weight. But every time you are resisting and coming out with innumerable excuses. Right? And then you feel guilt also. So you're not peaceful because you're only coming out with excuses, but at the back of the mind, you have that you have not been able to achieve it also. So again, you're not happy. Assumptions, when you assume about people. I remember when I was in a training, in that department, there were some 300 people used to sit, but all were not my training participants. Sometimes we will just meet somewhere and say, hi, hello. So one day, one of the person who I have never trained, just met me in the, you know, outside the restroom, and I just smiled and something was very nice. I complimented. She said, ma'am, you will talk to us also. I got a shock. I said, why I won't talk to you? And why do you feel that I will talk to others and not talk to you? How they are great and you are not great. So she said, no, because you are in this position. So I said, what does position have in mingling with people? In fact, for my position, I should actually more mingle with people. So, you know, there are a lot of assumptions people make. Expectations. when you do some help and you expect, you are going to, most probably people may not thank you. So then you're going to be disappointed. So whoever is appreciating you, accept it with wholeheartedness. But whoever is not, forget them, and you did it. You have done a good job. Somewhere you will get a result for that. You don't waste your time cursing them. Stop controlling the whole world, environment, situation, everything. Go within. Go within. Don't control the external factors. Today we know all with Corona how much we were able to control. How much money helped in so many rich people. Nothing. People just died paying so much of money. Right? Karam kiye ja. What Gita says. Right? Focus on the, don't focus on the result. Focus on the job that you have to do. Result will automatically come. No one can degrade you or hurt you without your permission. You are giving them permission to hurt, they will hurt you. You can draw your own boundaries. Don't allow them to hurt you. You know how you can take care of yourself. So it's all, and don't give any meaning to what people say. It is when we get hurt because somebody has formed some opinion about us or told us something, and we think about that whole day and waste our time thinking, how did she even talk about me like that? How did she even think about me? Maybe that person's environment, situation, how that person was born and brought up, from what angle she has spoken, you don't know. So just leave it. Sometimes what will happen is when you leave it off, that person will come back to you again and say, oh, I'm very sorry. I thought about you like that. So just leave it. Wait for the time to come. Don't waste your time and energy, tackling all these things, thinking about all these negative things. Now, if you can write down, or you can just visualize and take a snapshot later on of these questions. So all of you close your eyes. You can take a screenshot of this afterwards. What specific situation in life gives you the most satisfaction? Think about one specific situation. There may be innumerable, but something which is very, very dear to you. Think of that situation in life which will give you the most satisfaction. And remember what you have chosen. Now, do you feel abundant now? When I say abundant, I'm not talking only about money, I'm talking about abundant in every way. Are you filled with love? Do you have good health? Do you have wealth also? Right? Are you peaceful? So are you happy? So how nice at this feel, at this juncture, how do you feel? Nice or pathetic or miserable, or what do you feel? So if you do not feel abundant now, what are the three most things that you would like to be added to your life right now? Now you can think of your goals, what you want to achieve, because you are already climbing the happiness ladder. You are writing the happiness bank. You are writing the payment journal, right? You are writing the gratitude journal. So all you are acknowledging everything. Now think of what you want in your life. So add those three most important things that you would like to add right now to your life. I hope all of you have added. Then what is your biggest dream as of now that you feel must come true in order for you to be truly abundant? Maybe one biggest dream. Probably you want a house, you want a promotion, you want your daughter to be married, whatever it is. You want a job. Now think of events in your life that made your world brighter and happier. It could be a laugh of a small child. It could be that the food that you ate. It could be your marriage. It could be your job. It could be a promotion. What events in your life made your world? bring some 3 to 4 events, recollect those 4 or 5 events which made your world brighter and happier. Now, after actively, so you have already visualized, this is the concept of abundance, right? Keep the thought in mind and let positive emotions only come out. Let these thoughts and emotions take charge of you from now on, because now you are an abundance magnet. So you will be attracting only abundance. And keep your eyes closed. Imagine that you are now a being of pure energy. You are pure and unfettered by the burdens of the world. You are now free from all negativity and problems, and negativity cannot touch your mind and heart. As an energy being, you are absorbing all the positive energies around you. You're growing like never before, and as you grow, you move up and you feel the vibrancy and abundance of the universe. You're now a tower of energy spinning. Now imagine you're spinning with this complete energy and abundance around you. பம்ரம் சுத்ரா மாதிரி அப்படியே ஸ்பின் பண்ணுங்க அதை. அண்ட் ஆஸ் யூ அப்சார்ப் தி அபண்டன்ஸ் தட் யூ டிசையர், இமேஜின் ஸ்பின்னிங் வித் தட் அபண்டன்ஸ் எனர்ஜி. ஆஸ் யூ அப்சார்ப் எவ்ரி திங் தட் மேக்ஸ் யூ அபண்டன்ட், யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு கிவ் பேக் சம் ஆஃப் தி அபண்டன்ஸ் பேக் டு த வேர்ல்ட் ஆல்சோ. யூ பிகம் த சோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் அபண்டன்ஸ் டு தோஸ் அரவுண்ட் யூ, அண்ட் யெட் யூ நெவர் லேக், அண்ட் யூ ஃபீல் தட் யூ ஹாவ் எவ்ரி திங் யூ நீட் அட் திஸ் மோமெண்ட். As you give back some of the abundance, the cycle begins anew and you become powerful, even more abundant as time passes and your abundance defined. You can slowly open your eyes as you, yeah. I think I overshot the time.
No, ma'am. Thank you. Nicely finished with the practical things.
Okay.
Sonata, ma'am, you can carry out the question answers and what are things.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
So, any questions?
It was a wonderful session, ma'am.
Okay.
We are already in abundance of happiness. Okay. Voice also very soothing effect.
Okay. Anyone wants to ask anything?
Ma'am, I, yeah. I want to greet you. Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am.
Yeah.
I am Chitra from Tirupur.
Yes, ma'am.
Today we learned a lot of information from your session,
yeah,
for our abundant happiness.
Yeah.
From negative thoughts to positive events.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Very happy to attend your program. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yes, anybody else wants to ask anything?
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
My name is Amrut Mazumdar. I am practicing clinical psychology in Chhattisgarh, Raipur.
Okay.
Ma'am, I wanted to know two things. Can happiness, what you have presented, is used in the counseling sessions? Should it be used in counseling sessions?
Can you use it in counseling session?
Yes.
You can use small things. Definitely you can use this.
Because the time constraint is there. That is one question.
Yeah. So what I would say is that definitely you can use this in counseling session, right? asking your clients to suggesting, you can suggest them and advise that this is how you can be happy, and you can ask them to write the journal, you can do some kind of meditation, what we did, any one thing you can do at one particular session, no, so that next time you can do something. Definitely I do use it, definitely it brings a lot of results.
Another thing I wanted to ask is, in real life situations, like sometimes discrimination happens or partiality happens, and we feel very sad. It is a reality, not the, like, it is prevailing. A client comes with these problems, and how then happiness can be, like, he can ignore those negative event happening, presently happening, not in the past, but presently happening.
Happening. So what you can do is what I do normally, and that's what the Ho'oponopono, it's a Hawaiian therapy. Whoever is hurting you, send love vibrations to them. Whoever is under any kind of issue, send love vibration to them. Now you have an issue with your boss, actually he needs a lot of love vibrations. So you're not going to go and tell him anything. You just have to say four sentences within yourself, visualize your boss in your mind, and just say that I love you, thank you, I'm very sorry, please forgive me. It could be in any sequence. I mean, it's not necessary first you have to say I forgive you, I love you. You remember these four sentences: I love you, I'm very sorry, please forgive me, thank you. There was a psychologist called Dr. Hewlett, and he has written an, you know, the even Dr. Hooper is running this, law of attraction and Ho'oponopono, and this Dr. Hewlett has actually, where he has healed some around 50 to 100 people who were in the mental asylum without talking, without counseling them or anything. He will just open the file, and to every file he will just see the details, and he will keep saying, giving those love. He never in his, he was there for almost 6 months, he never has consulted anyone, never went and spoke to them, anyone personally. He just kept on giving this low vibrations to them, and all of them were discharged.
I believe that I have not done any mistake, or I have not hurt anyone or my boss for that matter.
Yeah.
What for I should ask for the forgiveness and say sorry?
See, what happens is that you have not done any harm, but your boss is having some misconceptions about you. So when you start saying this, you know, I love you, I'm very sorry, please forgive, because you are doing very well also is an issue for him. Some of the bosses will not like their, you know, assistants to do very well. So when you start giving this love vibration, you just try it for 1 month. You will see how your boss changes, or things will just clear for you. It is not about you, it is about him. He is the one who's causing issue for you, correct?
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
It was a very nice session. It was an excellent session. It was a motivating session also, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. Anyone else?
Abhijit, you can ask now.
Thank you, Sananda. Thanks for asking me. So, Mrs. Shyamala, appreciations from my side. Neat session from your side. So, my question is, you spoke about gratitude diary and happiness diary, right? I personally maintain a dream book, and I call my happiness book as Happy Highs. So I maintain two books, so dream book and a happiness book, and I can understand what you're trying to say. It is helpful, it does wonders. And I have this doubt.
Huh.
What's the difference between a gratitude journaling and happiness journaling? You know, I don't see a huge difference between both of them. You can just
incorporate
both at once, but you are mentioning both differently.
Okay. The point is that you have, why I am making it different is, you can write it in one book, everything. But when you are giving importance to happiness, whatever small things makes happy, in that you are not going to write it in the gratitude journal. Most of the people may not write it. So this is about, again, when you want to attract more happiness, you keep writing specifically whatever things has made you happy. right? Gratitude is what all you have. You have food, you have what you want to achieve, as if you have already achieved. Gratitude can be all the people who have done good to you. You are showing gratitude there. But somebody, when they talk to you, you are not...
I think resource person got some technical glitches. Let us wait for a couple of minutes.
Yes, sir. So another thing is, you must describing about taking a bath.
It's actually
enjoying the experience.
Voice is not clear. Probably we have a low network connectivity, I believe. So your voice is breaking.
Sorry.
Ma'am, are you there?
Maybe network issues, sir.
Yeah, network issues.
Yeah.
Abhijit, sorry, she's not in connection now. So due to some technical glitches, we will skip your questions, Abhijit. Sunita, ma'am, we can go with the vote of thanks.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Kindly accept our gratitude on behalf of American College Madurai and MS Chellamuthu Institute Madurai, Madras School of Social Work Chennai, Red Pond Educational Research Center, Yellow Pond Counseling Center, then Tamil Nadu Career Counselors Association, Tamil Nadu Career and Psychotherapy Association. We thank you, ma'am, and participants. Yet another new session tomorrow. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye.